Well, don't be bad at the game, man.
They knew the immediate threat. Like, this guy is the good guy.
Oh god, no. There we go. Double kill. Whoa. Look at that. Works for me though.
I know you don't get those often.
I am kind of weirded out by it, to be honest. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, give you a new kind of video. We're doing some tips and tricks in this video, guys. I'm gonna go through some different gameplays that I do and show you guys how to do well in Halo Reach. So in this one, we're gonna be doing some tips and tricks on Powerhouse. This is regular Team Slayer on this map. In general, whenever I get the blue spawn, which is gonna be the lower end of the map, I always go for rockets. It's the quickest route to the rockets. And you do have disadvantage of being at the low ground, but you have the advantage of being there first for the most part. So definitely you want to take part. So you can see I went straight for the rockets and went to go pick it up. It's super important to control these rockets. It's probably the most important thing to control on the map. As you can see, I can just have no problem when it comes to picking people off, because I was able to pick up those rockets just fine. And so what I'm going to just kind of do is just kind of control the area with these and just kind of cause some havoc. So what I'm going to do, guys, with the idea with this series is just kind of give some general tips and tricks on different maps and modes that I play. This was ripped from my live stream, so if you guys want to catch me up on Twitch, I stream every Tuesday and Thursday night, 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on my Twitch link. It's in the description down below. If you guys want to check it out, you can go more than welcome to check it out right there. So yeah, think about the power weapon controls. Obviously, when it comes to a map like Powerhouse, there's a focus rifle, gravity hammer, rocket launcher, grenade launcher, and a shotgun. So a good variety right there. And most of them are all of them except the gravity hammer are on 3-minute timers. And what do I mean by that? It means it's 3 minutes after the weapon was picked up. So since I picked up those rockets right about 11:45, you do 3 minutes later, it's going to be around 8:45 is when those rockets are going to pop up. So that's where I'm always keeping an eye on the timer in the lower right hand corner right there, guys. So that's one thing you absolutely need to keep track of when you're playing Team Slayer. That time right there is not just an arbitrary number to keep you up to date. Go like, okay, I only have 10 minutes left to play in this match. Like, no, it's very vital and very important for you to keep an eye on that timer. Keep track of things while you're playing this game. I know it's kind of a basic tip, but, you know, I'm kind of giving you guys basic tips to kind of give yourself some, just like from a below average or average player to get to like somewhat above average. Because in this game, I think I did a great job of just throwing mag control and power weapon control as well on top of that. And we all went 21-3. That's a solid match. If I can do that every time I play Team Slayer, I'd be quite happy. I also think a lot of people would be as well. So I'm trying to help you guys out here. So I'm just kind of sitting on top of this building here, and I realized I was getting a little overwhelmed right there, so I just gotta back this baby up right here. He's got a hammer, he's gonna try to chase me down and hit me. So I decided to kind of back up a little bit to this location that he either wasn't expecting or give me some more space between me and him, because obviously the closer he is to me, the better the advantage he has when it comes to the kill times in this. Now, you see, I picked up the Nita rifle. That is absolutely important to pick up. It spawns down there, and it's an absolute laser beam. Like, literally, laser beam. Like, this, you know, with the title update settings that they put into Halo Reach, that the bloom is reduced by 85%. Which means that, you know, obviously you can shoot your weapon faster with the reticle reset coming sooner, but with the needle rifle, with the update, the bloom retracts as soon as as you shoot it, and so then basically the weapon has no bloom. So if you're tired of complaining about bloom in Halo Reach, pick up a Nita rifle. That thing is a legit power weapon, guys. Don't sleep on that. It's an absolute monster. You can see right there, I positioned myself on that upper bridge to make sure to stop anyone going for the rockets. And I was like, oh wait, that's right, the rockets are up right now. And you can see that guy sprinting down below. He knew about that time as well, which is also very important to keep track of. Like, when you see someone like that sprinting towards that location with rockets, you're like, okay, this guy understands how to time weapons as well. You need to keep that in consideration. So you need to try even harder to make sure you're on right when that weapon drops to make sure you go pick up those rockets. And since I picked up those rockets, look at that. I was able to pick up like 4 kills, like super easy right there. And it's also very important to know that not just like, as I can see, the guy who was pushing me or just sprinting around to try to grab those rockets as soon as possible, did not blindly rush in there and try to do that, because you can see right there, Like, he just wasn't prepared for me to be, he wasn't prepared to defend himself at all in that situation. He was sprinting around the corner, blindly, you know, blinders on, just kind of running straight at the location. And so I was able to pick him off real easy right there. So keep an eye on the radar. Make sure that you know, you're not overextending yourself and controlling those power weapons, which is always uber, uber important when it comes to playing Halo Reach. You can see I spawned right here. I'm like, okay, gotta grab that needle rifle again. And whenever you spawn at the blue side of the map, especially right there, you absolutely always have to go looking for that needle rifle, guys. I swear to God, this thing is a game changer. You'll go from Joe to Pro from just using this needle rifle. And plus, it's fully auto. You don't even have to pace your shots. You just hold the right trigger, and then it shoots straight every time with no bloom. It's absolutely insane, guys. Like, I can't praise this weapon enough. But yeah, it's like, it's this will take you from a 1KD player to a 2KD player from just consistently using this weapon. So learning the spawns, where this weapon spawns, is absolutely crucial. So it does spawn at the bottom right where I just picked up this weapon. I'm trying to look at right now on the map. I don't see any. That's the only location where the needle rifle spawns. So if you hold blue, you absolutely have to check that location. And so that's kind of one thing to help out when you do have the blue spawn, because you do have that disadvantage of the low ground, but then you obviously have the advantage of that. You also have the focus rifle you can try to pick up, which spawns up every 3 minutes. You also have the advantage of picking up a rocket. So even though you get the low ground, you have advantage of power weapons. And so you definitely want to utilize that, which I certainly did right here. As you can see, I went 21-3 that match. Super quick work of the enemy team. Just really light touch on them, what you can see, what you can do when you're playing Halo Reach, guys. Keep an eye on the timer, control the power weapons, and make sure you maintain a high. And once you grab that, make sure you keep high ground, top of that DMR, and you'll be doing just fine. If you guys want to see some more videos like this, where I'm kind of dissecting gameplay a little bit and just kind of talking about my experiences and what my thought process is while playing the game, make sure to tap that like button. Let me know if you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what you thought about the video. I'm also looking to start to do a map review video, which I think the first one will be Zealot. So if you guys want to see that, make sure you tap subscribe on the channel, guys, so you can learn more tips and tricks on how to get better at Halo Reach. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace out.